media commentary, it's all up in arms, along with political opportunists demanding that government do something about high-priced housing in Vancouver. Now, at the same time, the Bank of Canada, all major banks, well-known economists like David Rosenberg and famed hedge fund manager Mark Cohodes are equally worried that the housing bubble is about to burst, pushing prices much lower. And if that happens, you can be sure a new cry will go up from the same people demanding government do something about the drop in prices. And just so you know, history makes it very clear that low real estate prices are a far bigger financial problem than high ones. I mean, Google the subprime crisis if you're not sure. But our commentariat isn't suggesting that, Lord knows. They want the government to instead move their magic dial just enough to satisfy them. Although, much like they're thinking, it's not clear what their price target is. Down 10%? Down 20%? 1907 prices? What? Because it's easy for government to take actions that will lower prices. I mean, they could simply push mortgage rates to 10%, make the minimum down payment 50%, or add 100% property purchase tax. Any of these moves will solve the problem of high prices. But, of course, the commentary virtually never mentions that the problem of high prices is only a problem for buyers. It certainly isn't a problem for homeowners and sellers. But government can't afford to do any of that. So the focus has shifted to foreign ownership. But there's a small problem. Foreign ownership plays a significant part in pricing at the upper end of the market. But surprise, it has nothing to do with affordability for first-time buyers.